Good Omens, a cult classic. Here we go. I'm gonna actually review this and hopefully I don't get flamed for everything I say about this book. Welcome back. Hello everybody, it is Anna. Today we're gonna be reviewing Good Omens, the British book that I don't understand because I'm an American slash Canadian. Canadian actually, so you know, we'll see how this goes. Now first of all, it's true. British humor does not translate well into American humor. But the thing is, this is British humor from like way back when, from like 20, maybe 30, maybe 40 years ago. So this is like old British humor, and that kind of stuff translates well into modern American humor because, you know, humor at that period in time, I believe, originated from British and came to us later on. So we kind of understand it a little bit at least, but not enough that I understood most of the jokes because I'm like absolutely certain, like vast majority of the jokes went over my head because I don't know any British actors, any British presidents, anything, or prime ministers, anything. So a lot of the stuff probably just went right over my head. I just whooshed it right over me. So, who knows? First thing to say about this is that the writing itself was very seamless. There are two writers, and both of them really, like, write this very well. Like, you could tell they're having a lot of fun, because it's just a lot of fan service fun. So, they're just having a lot of fun, and I can't tell who's writing at certain times, because I've only read Neil Gaiman, not Terry Pratchett, so who knows when he was writing, but it seemed like, from the end, he was a lot more fun to write with. So it seemed like his parts were a lot more funny, I guess. But I did laugh, actually, at many points during this entire book. So, of course, it is classified under humor, and I did laugh quite a bit. Despite not understanding the majority of the jokes, I did laugh a little bit, because some of the jokes were just wonderful. There's one joke in particular, it's like a two-page, you know, just a jokey scene. And what it is that there's this one dude, I think it's R.P. Tyler or something. This man, if he shows up, it's a lot of fun, actually, until he shows up. And then, eventually, Crowley shows up. And you won't know what I'm talking about until you read the book, so it's not spoilers, don't worry about it. And they meet, and the segment where they're talking is the most brilliantly funny section I've read in a long, long time. It's so much fun. It's like, it's so modern day funny. It's like, it's really tapping into something we all feel. It's like I would feel the exact same thing in that situation. I would do exactly what he said. So it's really like weird to see that, like, from an outside point of view, and it's so much fun. It's so much fun. And those were some of the jokes that I did understand in that situation, because it's a very situational comedy, but the specific references, those are kind of weird, and that kind of annoyed me. But you know, you just skip it. It was kind of hard to get into because you meet a lot of characters throughout the story. You meet like maybe seven characters, named characters, and you're like, which ones do I remember? Why am I meeting all these random people? Is it like Stephen King, like, I believe in one of his books, you just meet a bunch of random people just to see what the world is like while these certain few characters are going through it. And it's like, maybe five of the characters that are named, you want to keep track of. Like, they're very important characters. And I didn't understand that at the beginning. So I was just kind of like going through figuring, like, okay, forget about these guys. And then later on, I'm like, oh, these guys were these guys. That makes sense. So essentially, I think I'd warn you guys to remember these characters. The main two, you know who they are. Then there's this lady with red hair, I believe who it is, and there's Adam slash the them people. You need to remember those guys. And then one lady, a second lady. So both of the ladies you want to keep track of because all those people, they're really, really important. They come back later on, as well as one dude who's like has planes. But I don't know why that scene existed because that was kind of a dumb scene. But yeah, just like that, there's a lot of scenes that I think just should have been removed because they're there. They reference a lot of interesting points in the story that I remember. Like, I remember there's certain sentences that reference this, and it's really funny to, like, notice that later on. But it, in general, did not serve anything for the story. It's like, okay, well, the world is being built, but it's not that interesting. Maybe it could have been made shorter or something like that. The characters were fleshed out in those small stories, and I'm like, it's not about the characters, it's about the world. So get rid of that, just keep it about the world, you know? And again, because of the prose, I really didn't understand that much about plot specifically either. Like at the beginning, something very important happens to babies. That's really important to the story. And I could not understand it whatsoever. I had no clue what was going on. I was just because it's all British and I was just getting into the book. So I was not understanding it. I just came out of two Stephen King books. I just come out of that. I was trying to figure it out. I could not figure it out. So, you know, later on it was explained again. And that's where I did understand it. So that's really useful, actually. So props to the authors for actually making that like understandable later on for the American viewers. But a lot of things also didn't make sense because of like money, queens, king, blah blah blah, like small things like that just didn't make sense for me. And plot didn't make that much sense for me in certain situations. I'm like, why did they do this? What was the issue? Why couldn't they just do that? And it's like, well, it was probably there. Like, realistically speaking, these guys are really good authors. Like, there's no way they just forgot about that. And from what I could tell in the story, it was addressed. But I apparently didn't catch it or something, because it's just gone. So, I don't know. It wasn't a bad book. It's just like, I think my reading style, it's hard to read. It's a book that you have to actually pay attention and read. You can't just read passively. And I really did like the main characters. Those were really fun. So, that's, I guess, it. That's all I have. Thanks for this short review. Thanks for watching this short review. And I really appreciate all you guys watching. And if you did like this book, or you did like this review, let me know in the comments down below. I want to know if you guys have read Good Omens, because that's, you know, I haven't met that many people, but if you did, I want to know what you guys thought of it down in the comments, because I haven't met that many people. I don't know what people think about this book. So go ahead, let me know in the comments down below, and make sure to click on my Goodreads page if you want to see the books that I'm reading at the moment and the progress I'm making. Go ahead and do that. Now, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.